Hello and welcome to this Middle-earth strategy battle game painting video. In this video, we're going to share to paint the Witch-king of Angmar. However, by following the methods and techniques in this video, you can easily paint any other ringwraith in your collection. So when you're ready, grab those brushes, shake those paints, let's get started. Now, before we begin painting, the first thing we need to do is undercoat the model. And as you can see here, we've used Chaos Black, which is perfect for the colours of the Witch-king. Now the first thing we're going to do is do some dry brushing on those robes. We'll start with Corvus Black, it's a heavy dry brush, and then move on to a light dry brush with some Dawnstone. But first of all, let's start with Corvus Black. So what I'm going to do is just load up my brush a little bit, like so, not too much. And the idea of dry brushing is to remove as much of that pigment as possible. So I'm going to do some circular motions, some crisscross motions like that. And what we're aiming to do here is remove as much of that pigment as we can. So just move slightly off, and as you can see, there's just little bits coming off now. So what I'm going to do, start actually rubbing that across the cloth. Now we don't want it to go in the recesses, so go against the grain, if that makes sense. So you're not aiming downwards like the robes are going, you're going sideways like this. So it's actually just picking up the top parts of the folds of the cloth. Just keep doing that. We're doing this quite heavily. Every now and again you'll have to go back down and get some more pigment. With that first dry brush done, what we're now going to do is get Dawnstone and do a second dry brush, just a little bit lighter, to pick out some of those raised areas of the cloth. And just take your time and build those layers up. With the dry brush of Dawnstone now done, what we're now going to do is move on to applying the rest of the colours to these black details. We're going to start first by using black template, which we'll apply all over the belt, and also drop in the deeper recesses of those robes. Then we're going to get Skaven Blight Dinge. This is to highlight the lower sections of the robes. On the higher sections, so from the waist upwards, we'll be using Storm Vermin Fur. This just makes the cloth look a little bit more threadbare as well. So first of all, let's get some of that black Templar. So I'm just going to apply a little bit to the palette. This is not to thin it down at all. This is just to get more control and not to overload that brush. It's always important to get a good pointy brush as well. So what we're going to do here is we're just going to start coating all over the belt to start off with. You've got a few little bits to be mindful of. And when I was talking about dropping it in the deeper recesses, just for a little bit more contrast, I'm just going to go into those deeper sections. I'll just add a bit more punch to that black. Now that the black temple has been dropped in those recesses, we're going to get Skaven Blight Dinge and then just start layering places and highlighting on those lower parts of the robes, like so. So you can do some broad ones when you get big folds of cloth, like so. You can do some fine ones when you get like little ones here and there. With that highlight now done, what we're now going to do is use Storm Vermin Fur. We're going to use this just to highlight the raised parts, so the parts from the shoulders and waist upwards. I'm also going to use a little bit of this paint just to pick out some bits at the bottom of the robes so they look a bit more threadbare. With that highlight completed, our black robes are finished. So what we're going to do now is move on to picking out the metallic details of the Witch-king. We're going to start first by using Einhand Steel, then we're going to coat Basilicanum Grey over that. Just to make it feel a bit more aged and rustic, we're going to be using a little bit of Agrax Surf Shade after that. Tidy some of the raised areas using Einhand Steel again, and then finish off with a final highlight of Stormhost Silver. But first of all, let's start with our base coat. Now, of any base paints, what I like to do is just apply a little bit to the palette, and then just add a little bit of water just so it's not too thick and goopy. And just again, get my brush to a good point. Then we're ready. So we'll start with his sword first. Just work our way around. So there's a few bits on the Witch-king that are metallic, so just check the box art if you're not entirely sure. Now that we're base coated on the metallics, what we're now going to do is get Basilicanum Grey and coat all over. Just be mindful not to get this on any of the black robes. If you do, just tidy back up with the previous colours we used for the black robes. Now that we've darkened down that metal using Basilicanum Grey, what we're going to do is add a bit of age to it by using some Agrax Surf Shade. So what I'm going to do is just subtly drop that into some of the deeper recesses of all this metallic detail. Just make it look aged, old, not very pleasant looking. There we are, with those metallics now looking relatively dirty and grimy. What we're now going to do is get some Einhand Steel and pick out those raised areas. Just make things look a bit lighter on the sword and on the crown, etc. Those raised areas now tidied up, we're just going to finish off with a final highlight of Stormhost Silver. So I'm just going to try and keep this to the tips as much as I possibly can. I'm not going too mad, just little dots here and there as well. With that last highlight applied, all that's left to do now is base the Witch King in a colour scheme that matches your army. With the Witch King of Angmar now painted and based, he's ready to lead the legions of Sauron against the Free Peoples of Middle-earth. Now, there's a couple of things to remember when painting this model. Firstly, when doing any edge highlighting, take your time and try and maintain a nice point to your brush. Also, when using shades and contrast, try not to overload that brush as it can quickly run out of control. If you do find that happening, just use your brush to soak up any excess. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video. I hope you enjoy painting your own Witch King of Angmar, and we'll see you again soon. Bye-bye.